fourth operation is time reversal. For a signal, for a continuous time signal x of t, its time reversed version is represented as y of t is equal to x of minus t. Time reversal is also called time folding of a signal or reflection of the signal about the time origin t is equal to zero. Now let's understand the time reversal through an example. Consider the continuous time signal x of t given here, where at the position of t is equal to 1, we have a value of x of t equal to 2. At the t is equal to 2 position, we have a value of 1. T is equal to 3, we have 2. So in order for time reversal, we know the equation, it is y of t is equal to x of minus t. By substituting the value of t in this equation, we can get the values of y of t here. That is, consider when y of t is equal to t is equal to 0. When t is equal to 0, y of 0 will be equal to x of 0 itself. In this case, x of 0 is 0. If t is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of minus 1, which is also equal to 0. Consider t is equal to 2, y of 2 will be equal to x of minus 2, which will also be equal to 0. If t is equal to 3, then just like the previous cases, y of 3 will be equal to x of minus 3. As it is 0, it is also not shown here. For the case of t is equal to minus 1, y of minus 1 is equal to x of 1, which means at the position of x of 1, we have the value of 2. So y of minus 1 is equal to x of 1. So we have 2 here. When t is equal to minus 2, then y of minus 2 will be equal to x of 2, which is equal to 1 in this case. If t is equal to minus 3, y of minus 3 will be equal to x of 3, which is 2. So we get the reflected signal like this. This is for the continuous time case. Now taking an example in the discrete time signal of x of n, here we have the values of 0 at the position of n is equal to minus 1, 5 on n is equal to 0, 4 when n is equal to 1, 2 when n is equal to 2, and 1 when n is equal to 3. So y of n is equal to x of minus n. Y of n will be equal to x of minus n. So at the position of n is equal to 0, y of 0 will be equal to x of 0, which is 5 itself. In the position of n is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of minus 1, which is 0. On the position of n is equal to 2, we have y of 2 equal to x of minus 2, which is also equal to 0. T is equal to 3, we have y of 3 is equal to x of minus 3, which will also be equal to 0. For the case of t is equal to minus 1, sorry, n is equal to 1, minus 1, we have y of minus 1 equal to x of 1, which is 4. For n is equal to minus 2, y of minus 2 will be equal to x of 2, which will be equal to 2. For n is equal to minus 3, y of minus 3 will be equal to x of 3, which is equal to 1 in this case. Next is the fifth property, which is the time scaling property. Time scaling can be mathematically expressed by the formula y of t is equal to x of at, where a is the value scaling the time. It can be either expansion or compression. The time can be expanded or compressed. According to this equation of y of t is equal to x of at, we can determine whether it is time compression or time expansion. If a is greater than 1, a is greater than 1 means if a is a positive value, then we obtain time compression. And if a is less than 1, then we have time expansion. Consider the continuous time signal example given here, x of t. For t is equal to minus 1, we have 0 here. For t is equal to 0, we have 4. For t is equal to 1, 2. From the position of t is equal to 0 to 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 2, it has a constant value for itself. And during the interval of 2 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3, it is linearly falling down. So for the first case, let us take x of 2t. Y of t is equal to x of 2t. That means a is equal to 2 in this case. As a is greater than 1, time compression takes place. That means take the values of y of t here. For t is equal to 0, y of 0 will be equal to x of 0, that is 2 into t, right? So it will be x of 0, which will be equal to 4 in this case. For t is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of 2, which is also equal to 4. For y is equal to 2, then x is it will be y of, for t is equal to 2, y of 2 will be equal to 4, which means 0 itself. Y of 2 equal to x of 4, which is equal to 0. Then when t is equal to 3, we have y of 3 equal to x of 6, which is also 0. So in order to get the value, we know that this 3 has to be compressed. That is, 3 by 2 has to be taken. By taking 3 by 2, we get 1.5. So at the position of 1.5, t is equal to 1.5, this graph will become 0. And here also, at the position of minus 1, that is t is equal to minus 1, y of minus 1 will be equal to x of minus 2, which is also 0. And for getting this value, which is we are compressing it, is that is minus 1 by 2 is considered. So minus of 0.5 is obtained here. The graph, the time axis is compressed. Next, we are expanding the signal. That is, we are taking x of t by 2. X of t by 2 means we are expanding the signal. By expanding the signal means we are increasing the time axis. As a is less than 1, a here is equal to 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.5, which is a value smaller than 1. Hence, at the position of minus 1, we get the expanded value at t is equal to minus 2. 2 is expanded to the position of 4, where the x of t by 2 will be equal to 4. At the position of 3, it will be expanded to 6. All of them are doubled. So now let's look into the second example of time scaling. Here we have a discrete time signal x of n provided as 0 for x of n is equal to 0, for n is equal to minus 4, 4 for n is equal to minus 3, 3 for n is equal to minus 2, 2 for n is equal to minus 1, 1 for n is equal to 0, 2 for n is equal to 1, 3 for n is equal to 2, and 4 for n is equal to 3. 0 for n is equal to 4 is also provided here. So first we are considering a compression. That is, a compressed time signal is shown here. X of 2n is represented here. For calculating x of 2n, we write the equation y of n is equal to x of 2n here. A is equal to 2 in this case. For n is equal to 0, y of 0 will be equal to x of 0, which is equal to 1. For n is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of 2, which is equal to 3. For n is equal to 2, y of 2 will be equal to x of 4, which is 0 in this case. For n is equal to minus 1, y of minus 1 will be equal to x of minus 2, which is equal to 3 here. Minus 2, it is 3 here. For y of minus 2, where n is equal to minus 2, it is x of minus 4, which is equal to 0. So the signal compressed by 2 is obtained here. For the expanded signal, we are considering the question as x of n by 2, where it is this a is equal to 1 by 2 value. Here the time expansion takes place. Similarly, like the previous case, write down the equation first. Y of n is equal to x of n by 2, and substitute the different values of n. That is, for n is equal to 0, we have x of 0 equal to 1. For n is equal to 1, we have x of 1 by 2, which is 0 in this case. Y of 2 is equal to x of 1, which is equal to 2. Y of 3 is equal to x of 3 by 2, which is 0. Y of 4 is equal to x of 2, which is 3. Y of 5 is equal to x of 5 by 2, which is 0. Y of 6 is equal to x of 3, which is equal to 4. Y of minus 1, is equal to x of minus 1 by 2, which is 0 itself. Y of minus 2 is equal to x of minus 1, which is 2 itself. Y of minus 3 is minus 3 by 2. X of minus 3 by 2 is obtained, which is 0. For y of minus 4, it is x of minus 2, which is equal to 3. For y of minus 5, it will be equal to x of minus 5 by 2, which is equal to 0. For y of minus 6, it will be x of minus 3, where x of minus 3 is 4. So we have 4 here. Precedence. So while doing operations in a signal, that is while sketching a signal and all, there is a particular order for doing the operations. That is, first is time shifting, then time scaling, then time reversal, and at last amplitude scaling. Time shifting, time scaling, time reversal, and amplitude scaling. This is the method by which we have to do operations in a signal. So let's take two examples for doing, for checking this out. The question is, plot u of minus t plus 3. So for plotting this signal, we have to first consider the order of precedence. That is, we know that the order is time shifting, which is then time scaled, then the signal is time reversed, then finally amplitude is scaled. In this case, first of all, consider the unit step signal u of t. It is first shifted to u of t plus 3 value, because according to the order of precedence, shifting comes first. U of t is converted to u of t plus 3. Then no scaling is required in this case, but time reversal is taking place. So this u of t plus 3 value is then converted to u of minus t plus 3, that is a y of t value, in this manner. So we can graphically plot it like this. U of t signal, the unit step signal, is drawn here with the amplitude 1. Then we are shifting the signal. U of t plus 3 is taken, that is, as it is u of t plus 3, it is an advanced signal and shifted to the left side of it by 3 points from 0. So from t is equal to minus 3, we have u of t plus 3 like this. Then this signal is reversed. Reversed means that it will be in the opposite quadrant. At the position of t is equal to minus 3, we will have 3, and the signal is reflected like this. Now consider the second example. Here, plot 2 u of t plus 2 minus 2 u of t minus 3. So for doing this problem, let us split the signal into two. First, we'll consider 2 u of t plus 2, and then we'll consider minus 2 u of t minus 3. For considering 2 u of t plus 2, first we have to use a step signal. We are drawing the step signal first, u of t here. Then we are shifting the signal by 2. As it is plus, it is advanced signal and is shifted to the left by 2 positions. Hence, we get u of t plus 2 like this. Then amplitude is scaled in this case. Amplitude is scaled by a value of a equal to 2. Thus, we obtain the step signal as such. That is, 2 u of t plus 2 will be obtained like this. In the second part, where it is minus 2 u of t minus 3, here also, first we have to draw a unit step signal u of t. Then it is shifted to right by a delayed signal, that is u of t minus 3 is taken. As it is a delayed signal, from the position of t is equal to 3, we obtain the graph like this. For then this u of t minus 3 signal is then amplitude scaled to a value of minus 2 sin, though as a result at minus 2, at this value of minus 2, we get an inverted signal like this. In the next step, we have to add this u of t plus 2 signal and minus 2 u of t minus 3 signal. That is drawn here. The first signal is 2 u of t plus 2 and the second signal is minus 2 u of t minus 3. As a result, these two signals are added together. Here we have at the position of minus 2, the value of 2 is present in this case for exponent of t. Here it is, no value is present, that is 0 is present. So 2 plus 0, it will be 2. From the position of minus 2, the value will be 2, and up to the position of 3, t is equal to minus 3 in case of x2 signal. In this signal, t is equal to 3, up to this position, the output will be present. The rest of all will be subtracted. Hence, this is the output signal y of t. Thank you.